So in today's video, I'm going to tell you how you, the real estate photographer, can stay busy in the slow season. Run the intro. What's going on, guys? Welcome to today's video. And today we're going to be talking about the slow season for us real estate photographers and videographers and what we can do better to stay busy, to kind of help our business during these slow times. So first of all, I want to say, if we're just meeting for the first time, my name is Jonathan and I'm just getting back onto YouTube. My goal here is to help other real estate photographers, videographers, creatives make a full-time living doing what they love, which is creating content. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, consider subscribing down below. All right, guys, so let's get into it. This question actually comes from Matt Lucas Media on Instagram. Shout out to Matt. So he says, "Yo, man, any tips on how to survive the holiday season and remain productive within the business? First, let's talk about the seasonality of real estate photography and videography, okay? So from the months of about October to maybe January, February, depending on where you live, it obviously gets really cold. There's a lot of holidays and a lot of people take time off. They're spending time with their kids, their families, they're going out of town, they're doing, you know, the whole nine yards. During this time, a lot of people don't really want to sell their house. They don't want to have the burden of moving from house to house during an already stressful and already busy time of the year. So for that reason, real estate gets very seasonal. So from October to February, it gets really slow, whereas from March to September, it can get pretty busy. It can be really hard to kind of balance out your business to make sure that what you're making in the busy months of the summer can kind of help you sustain year round, because you're not going to be getting as much business as you are in the summer year round, right? So throughout the year, as I've learned, I have a better understanding of what my clients' needs, wants, and expectations are. And once I am able to kind of understand those three things, I'm better able to serve them. So what I do during this year to kind of help that out is I go in and I update my website. So now I've hit up my marketing company and I'm having them build out four new web pages on my website to better serve me and to better communicate messages to my customers. So I'm looking at them right now. The four pages I'm adding to my website are Airbnb photography, community videos, Compass listing services, and virtual staging. Now, let me go into depth why I'm adding these pages and how they're gonna benefit me. So these are four services that I've already been offering, but they weren't made publicly known, if that makes sense. Let's take Airbnb photography for an example. I'm adding a new webpage for Airbnb photography on my website, right? And on this page, it's gonna give all the details, all the ins and outs of what Airbnb photography entails, why it benefits the customer, and what the prices are. Now, what this webpage is gonna do is gonna better help me communicate to my customer what they're paying for and why Airbnb photography might cost more than, let's say, real estate listing photography. And that's a story for another video if you wanna get into that. But essentially, all in all, I'm adding these new webpages so I can really take the burden off of my back throughout the rest of the year during the busy seasons, like I said, from March to September, where instead of taking a phone call and getting on a call with a customer to explain why they're paying more for Airbnb photos and why they should get them and why they're gonna take, you know, 2 hours instead of 1 hour on location, all I've done is I've condensed all of that information into one single webpage where I say, hey, you know what? Actually, let me give you some more information on Airbnb photography. Can I text you at this phone number? Yes, you can text me. Okay, cool. Here's a link to my Airbnb photography page. And at the bottom, you're gonna see prices. And if you like the prices and the work, you can book an appointment by clicking down below. Now imagine if I get 30 calls for Airbnb photography throughout the year, and I don't have to have that long conversation with every single person about why they need photography, why it costs so much, what's included, yada, yada, yada. All I have to do is send them the link. They can go there, read all the information themselves, and then get back to me by booking an appointment. That saves me a ton of time throughout the year. So, in conclusion, during this time of year, I like to go back into my website and my systems and see where I'm having problems and where I can save time and tweak them just a little bit. The second thing I like to do during this time of year when it's nice and slow is actually take Christmas card photos. So I don't do this for the general public. I don't advertise it out, but I do have a really big family and a lot of friends. And a lot of the times from October to December, they always ask me, hey, can you take Christmas card photos of me and my family, of my kids, of my dog, this, that, and whoever. And I always say yes. I don't charge them an arm and a leg. You know, I'm happy to do it and I help them out. And it's a good way for me to make a couple extra $100 a week and stay afloat during these slow seasons by helping out others and really just, you know, getting my feet wet. It's sometimes as creatives, it's good to jump into another niche of photography, something that you used to do or something new. That way you can kind of just stay creative and try new things. The third thing I do during these holiday seasons when it's slow is I offer headshot photography. So if you're not very good with headshot photography, there is a little bit of a learning curve there, but it's not very hard. You probably have a lot of the equipment that you already need to take these headshot photos. All you have to do is practice on a family member or a friend one day, and I'm sure you'll get it down. There's a ton of content out there here on YouTube that you can watch. But what I like to do with these headshots is I'll offer them to not only some of my best clients, but also clients who really haven't updated their headshots in like 10, 20 years. And that's often the case with a lot of real estate agents. So this is a good way to make an extra $100 to $200, you know, on the side. It's gonna take you a couple hours and you can offer headshots to all of your clients that are already in your database. So if you wanna learn how I take headshot photography, I actually have a webpage over on my website that you can see my headshot photos, examples, and how I break things down to clients. And then there's also pricing at the end and what's included. So, I mean, by all means, if you wanna take my information, regurgitate it, and spit it back out at your clients, feel free. I'll leave a link down in the description down below. And lastly, the fourth thing that I do, the fourth thing that I do to my clients is I offer them to shoot their company Christmas parties. So I actually did one this past weekend where this is a really, really good client of mine. This is actually the client that helped me get started in real estate photography. And I didn't reach out to him. He actually reached out to me, but this is kind of an annual thing that we've been doing. So I'm able to show up as a guest, you know, communicate and talk with like the 30 agents that are there. So it's good for my business. I'm able to have a few alcoholic beverages, get some free food, and still walk away with a couple $100 for taking some pictures and shooting a video. It's really, really simple work. Good way to kind of get your feet wet and just, you know, mingle with your clients and have good graces with them and just be real cool with them, if you know what I mean. So this is a good extra service that you can do. If it's not too late, I mean, you can probably reach out to some of your clients now and ask them if they have a Christmas party coming up or any sort of event, New Year's party, anything like that. If they need photos and you're willing to do it, that's a good way to make an extra couple $100. Now, what I would do in this instance, if you're offering to shoot these parties, is I would offer them a three-tier like package thing, right? So I would say, okay, hey, client A, I have package one, which is photos only, that's gonna run you $200. I have package two, that's video only, that's gonna be $400. Or I have package three, that's photo and video, and that's gonna be $450 or $500. Essentially what you're doing when you have $200, $400, and $450 or $500, you're kind of leading them to pick package three because it's almost a no-brainer to them. For an extra couple $100 instead of just photo or just video, you can get both. And they love that kind of stuff. They love the content. They eat it up. And it's a good way, like I said, to just be cool with your clients. Anyways, that's all I have for today. I think that kind of sums it up. I didn't really plan on recording this today, but I just kind of freeballed it, and I hope the content came out good. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. Shout out to Matt Lucas, Matt Lucas Media. This guy's pretty cool. Shout out to Matt Lucas Media. If you guys don't know him yet, you should follow him down right there. Thanks for the question, man. I really appreciate it. I hope I answered it to, you know, the best of my abilities. If you guys have a question, feel free to send me a DM on IG. I'll try to get to it. The more specific with the question that you are, the more likely I will be to answer it. And lastly, what do you guys think about this new setup? pretty sweet, pretty cool, eh, whatever, what should I do different? Question, do you like this better or that? Let me know, side A or side B, should I have the light facing this way, should I have the light facing that way? Other than that, if you guys got anything out of this video and you really enjoyed, do me a favor, hit the like and subscribe buttons down below, because I promise this time, I do have a lot more coming in 2022. I have this studio set up now, so there's no more excuses. So that's it for this one. Peace out, y'all.